AJ, how did you do that?
Arguing with the official. Pass is to Devontae Smith, who gets a hit from Jordan Whitehead as a parting shot. As the clock hits zeros, and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers win it by 16, and Bruce Arians' team is moving on.
All right. Now to some news nobody likes, but we got to talk about it. The Eagles. Oh, man. It's all come to an end. The Birds lost to the Buccaneers 31-15 in a game that was hard to watch, to say the least.
Do not be misled by the final score, 31-15, as the Eagles lose to Tampa Bay. Their season is over. 9 wins, 9 losses on the season. This is the bottom line, really. This is among the worst losses in the history of this great franchise. Of all the stinkers they have turned in since 1933, and there have been many, this one is close to the bottom, if it's not the bottom, because this is not getting...
But the Buccaneers, they controlled the game from start to finish, making this one of the worst Eagles playoff losses in recent memory.
Oh, it was so embarrassing.
It was bad. It was bad.
It was terrible, but at the same time, like, you know, you move on.
I wish that there was a better showing today.
The looks on their faces say it all. They are stunned, but really they shouldn't be stunned, because it's a performance that really was culminated and fulminated by the coaching staff. Both sides of the ball were inept today. Both sides of the ball inexplicably.
All three sides.
All three sides. Thank you very much, Barrett Brooks. Appreciate it. This is when you play your best. This is when you rise to the occasion.
Call the back half of the season what it was, but they played a lot of bad teams, you know? And look, give them credit for winning the games that were right in front of them, but it created the illusion that this was team was better than it was, you know? And no, they weren't, you know? And they get into the playoffs and they hadn't beaten a team with a winning record. And to me, that was why I never really believed that this could go any different. I really didn't. Even though I kind of wanted to during the week, I was trying to talk myself into believing that they could win this game. I kept coming back to the fact they hadn't beaten a team with a winning record all year. What makes me think that they're going to go into Tampa and beat the world champs?
The playoffs. This is when you meet the moment, and this guy, Jalen Hurts, and let's face it, let's call it what it is. I've been on this guy's bandwagon since the jump, and if not just me, but many have questions about his future with the Philadelphia Eagles, his future as a starting quarterback, because he underperformed today to a fare-thee-well. Should Jalen Hurts be the Eagles starter next season? Go to NBCSportsPhiladelphia.com/pick-and-click. Vote as many times as you wish. Ray, that's what we're down to right now. Is it a legit question, do you think? And how would you answer it?
It's a legit question in the sense that I think it's the question that's going to be on the lips of most Eagles fans.
And Eagles management.
Probably right now.
Jalen Hurts picked the most important game of his career to lay an egg today. He looked like he was unpoised, which is unlike him. He looked like he was indecisive, rattled. I mean, the list goes on and on.
Nervous,
and unsure of where he should go with the ball and what he should do. And then he opens up, you know, the whole can of worms about the debate whether he's the guy. Listen, if you want to win games like this, the quarterback is the most important player on the field. And if Jalen Hurts is going to go into a playoff game and play like this, then we re-raise that question of whether he's actually the guy.
Jalen, we saw you walk in with a walking boot. How early did that injury affect you in this game, or did it affect you?
I think it's something we all know I've been battling with this last stretch of the games we've played in since I've been back. Regardless of how I feel, you know, we didn't play good enough today. I didn't play good enough today, and it's kind of where it is.
interception, the one to Devontae?
Yeah, I want to say Devontae got open on the play. And I was expecting a look. The safety came off the hash. I couldn't get it up as soon as I wanted to. Got it up there a little late. Safety made a good catch on it on the sideline.
What held the offense back early in the game?
I want to say this. I think for us as a football team, this game does not define us. It does not define who we are. It does not define us at all. And we know all the different things that we've overcome. We know the environment that we built as a football team and the organization. With the youth we've had, and which I've talked about all year, and I know as a football team we'll be back.
The 2022 Eagles, how do you want them to be different from the 2021 Eagles next year?
Yeah, I mean, I think you never want to put yourself in a hole, right, and where you're 2-5 to start things off. So I think what's important and where I'm happy with this team is that this team did get a little bit better each week, where we were playing our better football later in the year. So getting off to a good start, you know, not just being 1-0, but getting off to that good start in that first quarter of the season, I think is really important. Then we can do what our goals are, is to win the division and to get a home playoff game to make some noise there.
Just really proud of our coaches and our players and really the whole building sticking together. Obviously, during a season, you're going to have adversity. We knew this season was going to be some highs and some lows. I think we felt that during training camp, that we were kind of trying to figure out our identity, our personnel, and Coach did an amazing job with that. So really proud of him and his staff. I think that certainly not satisfied with where we are. We know there's a lot of work to do. And we started that. We started that during the season by re-signing our own free agents, which is a huge part of free agency, is to keep your own players. And we did that to kind of get a head start and a kick start into the season. But there's a lot of work to be done, and excited about the opportunity ahead.
Yes, we are in Las Vegas, Nevada, the city of sin, getting set for the NFL draft.
All right, so the Eagles traded up two spots. Their pick is now in. The Texans are now on the clock because the Eagles and Texans made a trade.
Jordan.
How you doing?
It's Howie Roseman. Yeah, we just traded up for you, man. You're an Eagle. Congratulations.
I appreciate it.
I appreciate you. Can't wait to get you here. We go national championship, and our goal is to win another world championship here with you.
Thank you.
Hey, Jordan. Congratulations, brother.
I appreciate it, man.
Happy for you, man.
Definitely. Yes, sir. I'm ready. I'm excited, man.
I know you are. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get you up here. We'll spend some more time together tomorrow, but super happy for you, man. You earned it.
Appreciate it.
Excited to get to work. We're going to win a lot of games with you, man.
Always.
All right, Jordan.
All right. I'll see you tomorrow.
Here comes Roger Goodell with the first of two Eagles picks. Again, they pick 18th overall.
The Houston Texans have traded the 13th pick to the Philadelphia Eagles. With the 13th pick in the 2022 NFL Draft, the Philadelphia Eagles select Jordan Davis, defensive tackle, Georgia. The Philadelphia Eagles have traded the 18th pick to the Tennessee Titans.
There's a trade, and they're not telling me what it is, so we're going to find this out together. Oh, my God! Do you see
what?
That? Do you see that?
The Eagles are trading for A.J. Brown.
Go.
How about this trade that just went down?
Wow, we thought it was going to be Deebo Samuel. Turns out A.J. Brown stole the show here.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Are you serious?
I'm not messing around.
Are you sure that wasn't like
no, I'm
a
not.
Misspelled
no,
chapter?
I'm telling
you. Eagles just traded.
How about that one?
18th pick and a third round pick for one of the best young wide receivers in the NFL.
Yo, A.J. Brown is everything we need. Listen, my guy Aaron Kevin said Howie's not playing checkers. He's playing chess.
We'll buy a zipper, hit the club, pay for about 10, get in, we crunk, lit, any. Yeah.
No, we walk around the world.
stepping out, giving a damn by where our feet lined at. Yeah. Get y'all mushed.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, hey, Arthur Juan Brown, 70 yards.
Sticks and stones, chrome on chrome. That's just what up on internet clones. Got them kissing
Arthur
through the phone. Clicking up so they don't feel alone.
He is a powerful
she came
man
in heels, but she left out on
I'm
the
like, let's do a long way.
I'm living every 24 that Kobe did. Shout out to the six.
Running faster than damn near everybody on the field.
I'm on 10 for the cake. Get a lot of love from 12, but I don't reciprocate. Take it from a vet, that's a rookie. Mistake,
hey. AJ Brown over the shoulder catch.
Hey, murder game. Hey, slow the game. Hey, murder game. Hey, slow the game. Hey, murder game.
Best receiver in the league. Best receiver in the league. Number one receiver in the league.
Boy, look, you the man. Boy, you, woo, you is the man.
Man, man.
Hey, let's do it, man. Hey.
Boy.
Let's do it, man.
Say no more.
Questions on the air yesterday about my future. So I decided I'd clear it up right now. Unfortunately, I've decided to announce that I am retiring from hosting WIP. But I'm definitely not retiring from playing for the Philadelphia Eagles. I'm having way too much fun doing that. Looking forward to another year in Philadelphia. And all my teammates, let's go dominate.
And he just announced he's coming back next season with your Philadelphia Eagles. Please welcome Eagles center Jason Kelce.
And the Rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air.
Hassan's homecoming.
A New Jersey native and former Temple Owl, Hassan Reddick, is now a member of the Philadelphia Eagles. The Birds agreed to a three-year deal today with the free agent edge rusher. Reddick has 23.5 sacks over the last two seasons with Carolina and Arizona. The Haddon Heights alum was drafted by the Cardinals in the first round out of Temple.
Thrilled, you know, when I realized that I would be coming here, you know, I was overwhelmed with emotion. You know, to be closer to my family and to be able to play back in the stadium where I, you know, I spent my whole college career in front of the fans that watched me grow as a player. It's a wonderful thing. It's a beautiful thing for me. And, you know, I don't think this story could have been written any better. To play in Philadelphia, 15 minutes away from home, right over Jersey across the bridge, to be drafted in Philadelphia, but you know, missed the Eagles by one pick, and, you know, to have this thing come full circle and now had a chance to come play back here, you know, get back in the link, man, it's wonderful.
Slugfest going early. Defenses have been the heavyweights to start this game. There's a heavyweight tight end in George Kittle slipping some tackles, reaching for the first down and getting out of bounds.
Brandon Graham is shaking up.
Brandon Graham was not putting any weight on one of his feet.
Boy, you do not want to lose Brandon Graham. He is an integral part of this team. And let's see.
Unfortunately, this one is a serious one. The doctor has already called for the little mobile cart.
Oh, wow.
But now Brandon Graham is getting help off the field.
He can just on one foot.
Yep, he can put no pressure on the left side, left lower body.
And this is his 161st regular season game, more than any defensive lineman in Eagles history.
Yep.
And Brandon Graham is out.
First time in cleats.
you know, just get the adjustment. Feet automatically sometimes, you got to get them adjusted. Even if you've been doing it, sometimes just having the cleats on, you got to get that mold. So, feeling good though.
Going 40 yards.
All right. Nah.
It's going to be a build up, right? Focus on your drive.
Somebody going to pay for this. Somebody going to pay for this. By yourself, too. I'd rather another player go through it with me. You know, in the weight room, it'd be cool because I got other players, but this right here, running, I need to see somebody struggling with me. For real.
When you play in the city of Philly, it's always big expectations, you know?
Fans out here are really passionate about this team, the players, and this game, man.
They hold guys to the standard.
It's a great buzz rolling around here. It's always dope.
You gotta have a hard shell to be here.
You know, this city, they want you to win.
We're gonna prove to you that we're the best.
Look, I be riding through my old hood, but I'm in my new hood. Same old attitude, but I'm on that loose. Yeah. They say they gon' ride me. See me never do nothing. Cause they know that's the reason they gon' end up on the loose clip. Or tomorrow on my wrist, bust down. We popping bottles like I scored a winning touchdown. Remember me dead broke, look at me up now. I run my city from South Philly back to uptown. Thank God all these bottles I pop. All the paper I've been getting, all these models I pop. I done sold $100 for my album got dropped. And I'm only 23, from the street now. Look at me, look at me. I'm a boss like I don't say. Shorty at me for a check.
We approach the day like every rep is the most important rep of our life.
Everybody to whoop some ass.
That's the dog mentality right there. When that cage opens up, our teeth are snarling, we're drooling, we're hungry and ready to hunt. That's what a team does. Now turn that music up.
I'm a boss. I'm a boss.
I'm a boss.
I'm a boss.
I play the shots. I cover calls. We in it. It's going down. Yeah, and the kid that with my motherfucker crowd. I'm a boss.
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 You said the only direction is to rise.
The Eagles are loaded. An impressive combination of talent and depth, experience and youth.
This is the second year for Coach Dan Campbell running these lines. It's the second year for Nick Sirianni in Philadelphia.
Like an engine, the Eagles needed to fire on all cylinders entering the first game of the season in the Motor City.
Under center again is Gunn. This time he gives off to Swift, who has a hole and more to the 35-40, 35 midfield. Down the sideline, finally tackled at the 25-yard line by Darius Slay. Second and goal for the Lions. They go with an eye formation. Under center is Gunn. Gives it off inside and bouncing outside and running in for the touchdown is Williams. The Eagles stopped him at the point of attack, but they didn't grab him and he bounced it outside and the Lions score first.
Jalen Hurts patiently waited for his opportunity. While the team fell behind by 7 points. All eyes were on number 11, as Hurts and best friend A.J. Brown went from 0 to 62 on their first scoring drive.
He completes it, A.J. Brown spinning downfield. Hurts in the gun, Hurts back, Hurts pumps, Hurts fires, complete over the middle. A.J. Brown, first down and 4 across the 40, up to the 42. And goal at the 1. Sanders standing to the right of Hurts. Fakes, rolls, walks in, touchdown.
The Eagles had an answer for the Detroit Lions and would ride that momentum.
Under center is Goff. Bows it off inside again, and they are throwing Swift back. There was bumping there. shotgun. Back again goes Goff. Up looking, firing, and it is almost picked off. Boy, they had a shot at that. Inside, plunging forward, Miles Sanders, touchdown! His first of the season, and the Eagles take the lead. Jake Elliott to put it over Justin Jackson's head and have the move it out to the 25-yard line. Goff takes the snap, backs up, lets it fly, and it is intercepted! Intercepted! Running with the football is Bradbury! James Bradbury for the touchdown! Pick six! Well, they were pretty upbeat on Hard Knocks. Today they are getting knocked hard so far. With a fourth and inches, and they go outside. Swift who goes inside the pylon for the touchdown. A lot of time left in this game. Far too early to feel secure. Hurts. Sanders breaks the tackle. He's at the 50, the 40. Penalty flag down in the backfield as he takes it inside the 30 and it's pushed. Gainwell pushing, shoving. Second effort, walks in. He walks in. He was in at the line of scrimmage.
The Eagles were flying high going into the second half. But things took a turn when Detroit decided to shift gears. The Lions had awoken.
Back, Goffin's back. He is hit as he fires the football. Complete touchdown, St. Brown. Goddard across the 10, across the 5, and he is down to the 1 yard line. Handoff, Boston Scott, forward, touchdown, Boston Scott.
Too strong.
But the Lions continued to hunt to get their team back from behind. The Eagles suddenly found themselves in a dogfight.
He plunges, he's in. It is third down and 4. Goff has trouble with the snap, and then he's sacked! Fletcher Cox got him! Brandon Graham was in there too, they got him! In the gun again is Goff. He is firing deep, and it is caught for a touchdown! DJ Chark! Potentially a 3-point game if they make the extra point. The Lions have scored 14 unanswered points. Eagles were up by 17. And now it is 3. If the Eagles pick up this first down, they win. Gives off. Sanders breaks the tackle. 35, 40, 45 midfield. They had Sanders, and he got away. Okuda finally brings him down. But that was a big run by Miles Sanders. The clock will tick, and the Eagles will open the season with a unbelievable win here in Detroit, one that could have been a lot easier, but it's still a win. They didn't just win, they escaped.
We said to ourselves on that sideline, we got the best O-line in football. We got the best backs in football. We got one of the best guys at quarterback skills in football. And we're going to end this game with the ball in our hands. That's dog mentality, guys. That's unbelievable job.
We know we got that feeling in our guts right now. We know we feeling that that's not right. So let's fix it, cause it's something that we can control. We control it. Now I say this. Not a doubt in my mind when I'm out there on that field, the trust that I have in y'all boys, mm-hmm. and the trust that we have in each other. Mm-hmm. And that was showed out that display. It was in that full tilt show today. Mm-hmm. All right. So keep that in mind when we're moving forward. The standard is the standard, and the only rising. Continue to challenge yourself, but fucking enjoy this win and down it! Yeah!
Yeah! Let's go! Eagles on three! 1, 2, 3! Yeah.
Jalen Hurts was a perfect 5-of-5 passing.
Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Get up, first shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious.
Gets it off, and he runs with the football and keeps it and takes it across the 5 and rolls down to the 2. And is he in? Yes!
He is.
Touchdown, Jalen Hurts!
Here comes the rush. He throws it high in the air, and it is intercepted.
The Eagles have battered the Minnesota Vikings. Today, for the first time, the Eagles faced the first pick in the 2016 draft, Carson Wentz. Starts the run. He fumbles the football, and let's see. I think the Eagles are on it. They are. Fumble Carson Wentz. The hit by Brandon Graham. Hurts back. Hurts is going deep. He wants Devontae Smith, who makes the catch and then goes out of bounds, but he has it all the way downfield.
Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us. Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight.
Jalen Hurts really that I'm so damn good?
Is this a question? Seriously though.
But then he dives and he is into the end zone. But Lark hands off inside and there is something there for ETN. Hurts gives it off to Sanders to the five. In for the touchdown! Goes Miles Sanders 10 yards out. Outside, Lawrence sneaks and he has it. Very slender. Now the Eagles are saying they have the ball.
They said the football came out.
They lost. Standing back at the 15. Hurts this time gives it to Gainwell. Up the middle. He took for the touchdown.
Oh, straight ahead.
I mean, why? They played in the same weather we did. Why would we sit here and make weather an excuse for anybody?
Lippin was able to deny us. I'm so proud how this team played. How we handled the conditions outside. We were able to be pretty efficient in everything we did. That's a great team win.
Let me tell you, Jalen Hurts did a heck of a job in this game considering the conditions. The Eagles have never won in this stadium. They've played here four times, including in an NFC Championship game, but they are 0-4 in this stadium.
I feel like we have to point to Jalen because everything else is so complete. Like, I have no concerns at all. I'm not concerned about Jalen either.
He is firing, leaping reception, A.J. Brown again. It was first and goal. Hurts with a full house backfield. Hurts sneaks again, and we are looking, and he is in for the touchdown. Jalen Hurts with the sneak punch.
I don't know. First down, he fakes, he's back, he loads up, he is going deep, and it is intercepted! It is intercepted! Picking it off!
Big bodies, they know how to push the pile, he pushes the...
And takes it to the 22, where Epps makes a saving tackle.
This is the moment, tonight is the night, we'll fight till it's over, so we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us, like the ceiling can't hold us.
Body, the kick is underway, the kick is... No good! The Eagles are going to be 5-0! He missed it! He's still Captain Nickers!
I'm waving all the touchdowns and all that. We're getting busy.
And the Eagles will be and will remain the only undefeated team in the National Football League.
Wow, that sounds pretty sweet. Could you say that again, please?
Welcome back in to speak. We got a little bit extra for you. Dave Hellman, he's covered the Cowboys for 10 years, literally knows more about the Cowboys than anyone on television. They got the biggest matchup of the year. Cowboys-Eagles, it's the biggest game thus far. Dave, I would go as far as to say this. If the Eagles can't beat the Cowboys on Sunday with the world watching at home, Cowboys don't have Dak Prescott, Cowboys don't have Tyron Smith, then the Eagles will not be a better team than the Cowboys this year.
It's going to come down to stopping the run. I said yesterday, when Dallas hands the ball off 25 times or more, undefeated this year.
Like, if Jalen Hurts can play a well-rounded, well-balanced game against this defense, then honestly, I will raise him a level in my mind in terms of what I think he's capable of.
If Jalen Hurts wins this ball game, then I will say he is there. I have yet to say that he is there.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
Truth be told, I believe winning and losing is dependent upon the quarterbacks. Point blank, period.
Like a big one, and it feels like a UFC fight.
Yeah.
Because of the trenches. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a better defensive line right now in all of football than the Dallas Cowboys. I don't think there's a better offensive line than the Philadelphia Eagles.
Interesting.
That Philadelphia Ride Eagles offensive line. They're going to be like, you tell us when, champ. Like, and it's going to be clean, and it's going to be That's in good the answer. Whistles.
Good
and I love it. But this rivalry, these people hate each other now. Like, my wife's from Philly. Stephen A., I know you worked there. They hate the Cowboys.
Plenty of times in the past. So to pull that off without Dak says to me, this is one of the four or five best teams in the league, and they don't even have Dak Prescott. And that now, you know, we talked about it on the show. They have a high ceiling. Now you're thinking, man, if we have a quarterback that is the reason we're winning and not just a guy that we're trying to limit his mistakes, that's a scary thought.
If you lose tonight at home to Cooper Rush, you guys ain't squad. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing. You lose to your arch rivals at home and they flip the table. And it's not Dak who, you know, who's beaten you guys senseless recently too. I'm talking about Cooper Rush. And I would just say this. We've shouted out the secondary a few times. This dude has not thrown an interception in professional football this season. You gotta go get him. Slay, if you're Slay, you're not Darius, you just Slay, go get an interception from Cooper Rush. All right, go get one.
That's what matters the most. Taking it day by day, trying to climb every day, and just winning the day. You know, that's the mentality I have, and I think that's the mentality we have as a team.
We're not looking behind us. We're not looking ahead of us. We're looking at what we have to do to go 1-0 today so we can go 1-0 this weekend.
You know, you don't want to make the opponent the focus. You want to make your teammates and your own self the focus. And so, you know, we know it's a big game. We're excited to play the Cowboys, but more than that, I think we're excited to continue to grow and play with each other.
You know, guys, I've thought a lot about this week, and it's focus on the process. No one means more to us than we mean to each other. No team motivates us more than what we mean to each other. This is the biggest game of your year because it's the next one. It's the next one. It's an opportunity for us to get better and play for each other. No opponent, none, is greater motivation. Let the fans get excited about the opponents. We get motivated to play for each other more than our opponent. That's a team. It's all about us. It's all about us. Because it's easy to get wrapped into the game and the rivalry and all that. It's f***ing easy to do that. This was stupid on my part last year. It's f***ing easy to do that. It's about us. It's about playing for each other. It's about wearing this f***ing t-shirt, not that f***ing t-shirt. Us playing for each other means more than anything else. It's a huge game to the crowd and the media. That's great for us. We're f***ing home. This crowd's gonna be rocking.
E-S-E-S!
And I know this room, I know we've yet to touch our ceiling. We've yet to touch the best possible, you know, performance we can put out there. We ain't did nothing yet. And I think this whole entire room, we got another level we could take it to. And to be honest, man, I ain't hungry. Coach Star always say hungry dogs run fast. I ain't hungry, I'm starving for this.
What you talking about? Gangsta moving silent. And I don't talk a lot, I don't say a word. I don't say a word, was on my grind and now I got what I deserve. Hold up, wait a minute. Y'all thought I was finished. When I bought the ass tomorrow, y'all thought it was raining.
Flexing on these. Sound like Papa on his
finish. Double Olympian, that's my team, Rose, the captain, I'm lieutenant. I'm the type of cannon, yeah, man, casting grind like
no,
I'm broke.
That
Lambo, my new
chill, ride like my ghost.
I'm riding around my city with my hands on my toes. Cause these boys be dead, and I gotta make it back home. Cause my mama need that bill money, my son needs some milk. Try to take my life, they f*** around, get killed. You f*** around, you f*** around, you f*** around, get smoked. Cause these Philly f***s I brought with me, no f*** around, no joke. No, all I know is murder. When it come to me, I got him that's rolling. I got throwing beans, I done did the DOA, I done did the KODs. Every time I'm in that f***, I get to throwing 30 G's. But now I'm hanging out that drop hand, I'm riding down no collar. They let me earn back home, that young be wild. We young, we mobbing like Batman.
Slay,
what up?
Go get an interception from Cooper Rush.
What up? Right, if you ain't
up
about that murder game, then shut up. If you dip me in your ass, I get your pussy stuck up. When you touch down in my hood, no, that tour life ain't good. Kept me down in MIA. And then he came on wood. With that Puma life in my feet, like that little engine I could. Boy, I slide down in your block, back on 12 o'clock. And they be throwing deuces on the same, they watch. And I'm the king of my city, cause I'm still calling them shots. In these lanes, talking that bull, the same, that flop. I'm the same from birth to with them that raised that lot. The same that came up and I had to wait for my spot. And these waiting on me, waiting on me. Still on that hood, my Rolls Royce on me. They gon' remember me, I say remember me. So much money, your friends turn to your enemy. And when this beef, I turn my enemies to memories. With them, they go from 40 and up to the key. Hold up, bro, turn rich. Love the game like Mitch. And if I leave, it ain't done pretty. I'm gon' steal my... It was something about that rollie when it first touched my wrist. Had me feeling like that dope boy when he first touched that. I'm gone.
I want to give gratitude to everybody in this locker room right now. Everybody in this locker room, because we talk about being a family. We talk about what that mean. We practice that every day. But today, we play together. Today, we had each other back. Today, we play like a family. We play like a family. And we still did what? We still left money on the table. We still left that. And I admire the faces that y'all have here. Like, that's the, I love that. Mm-hmm. I love that because we know what we can do. And we know what we can be. And we know it's in our hands. And that's how it's gonna always be. But we continue to take these steps and take advantage of every opportunity we have moving forward, and we can be a really dominant football team. Every time, every play. But we gonna turn up in this game! I'm proud of y'all, man. Hey, family. We a family. We go hard together. We go through everything together. Everything together. Family on three. 1, 2, 3.
The camera was on me.
That's worse.
Camera was on.
Oh my God.
Take one.
Cut.
Nah, keep rolling.
I got you.
Nope. Okay, 0-2.
Man, you ain't made none either.
5 years from now.
Hey!
The season, 20 points in the second quarter. Let's start there.
You could tell early that Cowboys offense was going to have problems moving the ball against this Eagles defense. They did a fantastic job in the first half, allowing the offense eventually to find their rhythm. And what has become customary in the 2022 season is that the second quarter explosion happened again. Mm-hmm. So they were awesome in that second quarter. The fact that Jalen Hurts able to move the ball through the air and on the ground when they needed to. I thought when we got back to running the football, I thought we started to take this game over.
I thought when you look at the defensive, just the start to this game, to go punt, whew, pick, turnover on downs, punt. Really good start to this football
Jalen's
game.
Jalen's playing MVP football, and I love the way he's playing right now. How he approaches the day, how he attacks the day. I just love how he's leading this team. But you got to give credit to this defense, man.
Attention, please. Attention, please. This here feels like a whole entire world collapse.
Kidnap that fool!
It's the perfect timing. You see the man shining. Go and get the damn diamonds.
Eagles wide receivers have a Batman cape.
Dude.
Tell me the story behind it.
Well, the story is Darius Slay was in an interview, press conference. I don't know what he was in. Essentially, Slay was like, you know, all of our options are bad.
Because y'all know y'all see it with dark vibes, swole. And, you know, he just looked like a swole Batman. Y'all cannot tell me he looked like a swole Batman. Devontae's a skinny Batman. Quez is a fast Batman. So what they got, we got three Batmans on the team, but we got one swole, one skinny, one fast. No Robins. We've got no backups, no Robins. We got no sidekicks. We got nothing but Batmans. You know what I'm saying? They boys lie.
They're all Batman.
No boy wonders.
Yeah.
That's a solid take.
You said we got swole Batman, skinny Batman, and fast Batman.
That's a good bit.
That's grade A stuff from a man Slay.
Are you ever going to be able to wear the cape?
Hey, listen.
Are you fat man? Fat Batman?
Listen, if we score on a screen, I'm getting that cape and I'm being fat Batman. I promise you that. That is going to happen. The next screen we score on, Fat Batman is going to be on the sideline.
Who'll be your Batman?
Fat Batman, of course.
So the Batman crew is growing. Jason Kelsey wants in as a fat
Batman. So I told him he's not the fat Batman, because honestly, I'm first sexiest on the team. He's the second sexiest. Then Lane is third sexiest. Like, well, I'm first for sure, but Lane, yeah. I told him y'all a sexy Batman. So if y'all put the cape on, y'all gonna be the sexiest Batman in the world.
Shady, I'm thinking about it now. They're 8-0. The Eagles won a Super Bowl a couple years ago, but they didn't even start 8-0 that season.
Okay.
What in the world could stop the Eagles?
That's a good question.
Nothing. There's nothing you can do to beat us, to stop us.
The only thing I think can stop the Eagles, it's probably the Eagles, right? I think if we turn the ball over, if we don't get turnovers, I watched earlier in the game where the Texans were running the ball up and down the field, right? Now, granted, my big dog wasn't
Jordan
there.
Jordan Davis
wasn't there. So I kind of could see that a little bit. But other than that, it's really about us. And that's the scary thing, is that you don't have to worry about no part of your team, on the defense, on the offense, special teams, turnovers, none of that. You just got to worry about handling the business up front, catching the ball, the small things, the basics, tackling, catching, because we are the real deal, and everybody knows it. And listen, 7-0, or 6-0, 7-0, 8-0, another one, 9-0, and then before you know it, we'll be undefeated for the whole year. So Philadelphia Eagles, nothing to worry about, baby. Just stick to the basics, play football, and win games.
Down in 20. Jalen Hurts without a fourth quarter comeback in his young career at home. He's done it twice in the NFL. This one is shot. Watkins a diving catch. Ball comes out. Commanders pick it up at the 15-yard line. And another takeaway by this Washington defense. Forrest comes away with it. And Quez does everything right. That ball is out. He doesn't get touched as he goes to the ground to make this catch. And then when he comes up, just good pursuit there on the backside, making a play. St. Juice is the one who knocks it loose. And this is a quiet stadium as Washington takes over at their own 27.
Honestly, in the moment, you know, after the catch, kind of bounced right back up off the fall or whatever. So it wasn't an instinct of just trying to make a play. When I caught it and I knew I was, you know, wasn't touched and I would bounce right back up, I was just trying to, you know, get to the end zone and make a play. And after the play, you know, after the fumble, I just took it, you know, as me just trying to make a play. And I was just trying to, you know, get out there and, you know, make up for my mistakes.
When you look at a guy like Quez, you know, obviously he had the fumble and everything, but do you kind of look past that and the ability of him to get open deep down the field?
We'll never let a one play define somebody, and we'll never let a play, you know, Quez is, when he's been called upon this year, which hasn't been as much, right, because of AJ and Dallas and Devontae, you know, when he's been called upon, he's made plays. And, you know, he obviously had a big fumble this week in this game, and he knows that, and we'll work to fix that, and he'll work to fix that. But we got a lot of confidence in him. And when I tell you we have confidence in somebody, that's not like blind faith, right? There was all the reps that we've had in practice with him last year, every rep this year where he's taken advantage of that opportunity. He's just continued to put his head down and work. And so, again, that's what we say with the roles. Hey, this might be your role. This is what you need to do, but this role can change as the year goes on, and you got to be ready to excel in the role that you're called upon. And how do you do that? You just try to get better every single day. So when your role increases, you're ready to go.
32-21 Washington, perfect season over.
Did you pick Washington?
No, I didn't pick Washington.
Okay, go ahead.
The problem is stopping the run. Mm. Since Jordan Davis, the big DT out of Georgia, they gave up 168. They gave up 162.
Stand that we usually, because history tells us, you anticipate a loss is how you go down. And the fact that Jalen Hurts wasn't that great, the defense couldn't keep the Commanders off the offense, off the field. You combine all of that together, and I say that doesn't make for a good loss in my estimation.
They had the ball. They had the ball less than 7 minutes on offense.
6-11.
Now, how many times have we seen that throughout the course of these 8 games where the Eagles have controlled the clock, controlled the line of scrimmage? We got beat up front. Our defense got a black eye right now. They got beat. They got the hell beat out of them.
Skip, look. And what I don't get about the Eagles, 4 rushes in the first half. Now, it seems to me, now maybe it was just early in the game, but it looks like to me A.J. Brown was nicked. And so the Eagles say,
he got nicked on an early catch where he came out of his break. And it looked like he pulled his calf or something.
So I'm looking at the game and saying, okay, so you thought the best, like A.J. Brown, our best receiver, he's hurt.
Yep.
So the best thing for us to do is to ask Jalen Hurts to drop back and throw the ball more. You are a running football team. Most of your success comes off of RPOs. Mm. To ask Jalen Hurts, and he has improved throwing the football, Skip, but to ask him to drop back and just sling it, you're setting yourself up for trouble.
Mm. Who knows what's coming up next week with the Colts?
You want to be the best in the world at something, it's about your detail. And details don't just automatically show up. You got to earn the right to be detailed. I listened to the defensive meeting, right? You got to earn the right to pass rush. I love that, right? You got to earn the right to be detailed through your process through the week. We earn the right to be detailed tomorrow because of the way we went through everything.
8:56 to go in the third. Fake the handoff. Ryan to throw. Protection breaks down and Ryan is smothered on the play. And Ndamukong Suh along with Linval Joseph, the two newest members of the Eagles, get home.
How about paying off that acquisition?
Philadelphia's defense has kept them in the game. Without the defense, yep, the Eagles might be done here at the final stages of the third quarter. Instead, it's just 13-3. Trying to add to the Colts lead. McLaughlin. It is no good. It got pushed to the right.
Hey, we're getting out of this. One play at a time. Go.
Second and 10. Pulls the trigger, end zone, touchdown, Quez Watkins, Philadelphia back in it, and we've got a 3-point game.
Let's go! You earned it! Let's go!
Ryan looking. Ryan in trouble. He's sacked. Back at the 19, Hassan Reddick.
And this Eagles defense has done it again. They have kept their team in this ball game in a big way.
Third and goal. Philly down by 6. Hurts will run. Takes it in. Touchdown! Nothing in front of him except the end zone. Now the Eagles are an extra point away from taking the lead.
Now they say a star was born. I think a star was made today in Jalen Hurts.
Indy still needs yards for a shot. Ryan is sacked. He got swallowed up at the 33. Brandon Graham. Big time play for Philadelphia. The Eagles rally. Nick Sirianni back to take on his former team. And the Eagles come from behind. Effort will end with a W.
Welcome to Philly. Hey, it's okay to get emotional after one like that. It took all 60 minutes. Defense, great job. Great job, defense. They went down and drove the first time, and then it didn't, then nothing. Nothing. You earned the right to pass rush at the end right there. You guys did it the entire game, and we were behind the entire game until the f***ing end. Until the end. Hey, I don't got a lot more to say. I'm pretty emotional. Great job. Happy for everyone in this room. That was a tough win.
Go.
Will you use the coat? Hey,
Scotia.
You can do it! You can do it! Yeah! Hey, those guys mean a lot to me, but not even close to what you guys mean to me. This is a special group. Let's pray. I appreciate that, guys. Let's pray.
So who are you going with, man?
I don't have a foundation here, okay. But I want to do one locally.
Okay.
I want to try to get in the movement of stopping gun violence.
Okay.
You know, and I want that to be like a part of my shoe. You know, I want that to be kind of like, you know, so I definitely want some splashes, you know.
Okay. So Wear Orange is an association that deals with gun violence, and Orange has been kind of associated with stopping gun violence. Mm-hmm. We can transition like an orange to red fade. I think that might be nice, especially if it draws into like maybe a black in the back, so that way it really pops. And then in the front, where we do the orange, we can deliver some sort of messaging, you know, stop gun violence, but we can make it really stand out.
My initial plan was to come in here, it was like a lime green, but you guys made a lot of sense.
Well, listen, if you change your mind,
no.
Give us a call.
I like this idea. I like where it's going.
Okay.
Y'all made mine quick.
That's what we're here for, man. Thank appreciate y'all. You. Thanks, you have a great one, man.
All right. Thank y'all.
You know, A.J. Brown was a second-round draft pick of the Titans a couple years ago, but he was traded to the Eagles in the offseason, signed a big-money deal. Needless to say, might be some emotions on the line here today.
Well, of course, it's going to be an emotional game for A.J. Brown. How could it not be? He thought at one point he was going to play for Tennessee forever.
Here's Hurts looking to throw, goes far side. There is A.J. Brown, makes his first catch against his former team. First down, blitz is coming. Hurts sees it. A.J. Brown on the cross, in stride, and a first down. The former Titan has his second catch. Blitz coming. It's picked up. Hurts says he's going to go deep. A.J. Brown is there. He's got it. Is he in? Touchdown.
Right, so his left foot was in. I'm going to be curious. Was this right toe in?
No.
No. Oh, that was a moment. You know A.J. Brown was thinking of that play.
He was determined that it is an incomplete pass.
So after all that, it's second and 15. Hurts. Lofting deep again. Brown is wide open, and he catches. He's going to walk in backwards.
Return to the king. Return to the king. Was gone for a while, now I'm back to claim the throne. Return to the king. Return to the king. Snatch that crown, yeah, it's good to be home. All rise, all rise, all rise, all rise. Royalty feels so alive. Return to the king, return to the king. Everybody put your hands in the sky.
A.J. Brown's had this game circled. Former team coming into his place. He's been unstoppable.
Honestly, our biggest thing is, you know, just keep doing what we're doing. Keep being hungry. Keep having that dog mentality and never get complacent.
Let's just continue to grow, continue to connect, and obviously taking it, you know, one game at a time, and not looking forward to anything.
Still that same, the uniform, but it's stolen. Ryan sporty, acting sporty, can't control it. I'm doing fraud, got that bag, yeah, I'm transporting. I got that bag on me, feel like I'm transporting. He dropped a mixtape, thought I would have reposted. I ain't posted mixtape, cause I'm f***ing shorty.
the fourth time in their history, after a 35-10 demolition of the Titans here in Philadelphia. Hurts was incredible again, four total touchdowns. A.J. Brown, 119 yards and two touchdowns against his former team.
Saw you FaceTiming with Jalen. He's your best friend. How special is this going to be?
Man, it's going to be real special, man. I'm so excited. I'm playing with someone who thinks like me. I talk to him every day, regardless of this football stuff, but I'm so excited just to play with him. And he's a quarterback and I'm a receiver, so we get on the same page quick.
As everyone knows, he's my best friend. We always talk about playing together. And now here we are in Philly playing together. He's my quarterback, I'm a receiver. And it's been everything I imagined, you know.
It's kind of a fine print in your contract, right? You got to win the locker room as well as the huddle.
Well, I think for the two of us, two of us is natural. You know, for a long time, he always was at Ole Miss. I was at Bama. Or he was in Tennessee, I was in college. Or I was in Philly, you know. So now, I see him every day. it's great, obviously, having a friendship. But when we come in here, like, you know, he said it to me, like, we two CEOs of the business, and that's how we're going to operate.
Hey, Jordan, how's it going?
Hey, Jordan, how you doing?
I'm doing fine, man. Hey, Merry Christmas, man. Hey, it's Tom Brady. Hey, how's it going, man? Merry Christmas, it's Tom.
No, but I was just trying to see, like, what y'all think. Like, you know, with us, is it more like ad-lib stuff?
Yeah, we're just trying to, so the whole vibe of it is supposed to be kind of like we're at, like, a bar. We're snowed in, and we're just singing some Christmas songs in Philadelphia.
Make sure you get, you
got Silent Night. You got that?
Yeah, get some Silent Night, yeah. Let's hear that.
Hold
on. It's a real silent.
Hey, man. Merry Christmas.
Hey, son. Merry Christmas.
PG, what's your favorite Christmas tradition?
One of my favorite Christmas traditions. Hey, Philly. Merry Christmas.
Be good, Philly. Santa's coming to town.
Oh boy, that was too sweet. That was too sweet.
We have eight full boards and we have nine ultimate. So that's 17 in total. Pro Bowl, Hassan Reddick. Lee Sledge. Miles Sanders. Jason Kelsey. Lane Johnson. Landon Dickerson. Jalen Hurts, A.J. Brown, Dave Alternate, Rick Lovato, Isaac, Jordan Mailata, Devontae Smith, James Bradberry, B.G., Josh Sweat, Fletch, Hargrave. I agree.
Javon got robbed. Simple as that. He got snubbed. Whatever the bloody saying is. But it's pretty bad. I'm not gonna lie. It's pretty bad. Those guys that made the Pro Bowl, the film don't lie, man. And those guys have been playing A1 all year.
End zone ahead. Touchdown. 22 yards. He straight up sliced them.
I think it's the competition for sure, because, you know, everybody trying to do good, and everybody is doing good, but I think it's more of our togetherness, people that's really happy for each other and people making plays. So it's just all about us playing together.
You hear the saying, it's better to be lucky than good? They're lucky and good, right? We know how talented they are as a team and how well they can play and how many different ways they can beat you in all three phases, but they stayed incredibly healthy on top of that. And when you take a team that has the talent that Philadelphia has and then they're staying healthy, I mean, it's been amazing for them to have both of those aspects for their team.
Hurts to run it, got around Morrow, got stopped by Gibson. Hurts slow to get up. Worst nightmare for the Eagles right here.
This is the one you can't afford, right?
263 pounds of Gibson landed on Hurts.
Did you know there was some issue after the game?
Yeah, I knew. I knew when it happened. I'm very aware of my body, and I'm pretty good at kind of overcoming those different things. So nonetheless, nothing changes with my approach this week.
I mean, I think in the end, that's what it's all about. You know, I know as a team, as players, as individuals, we all have things that we want to accomplish together. And ultimately, we want to find a way to get them done, you know. So it's a day-by-day thing, you know. And I think for us, we want to trust in the process of us just getting better and getting ready for this game in front of us.
Quarterback Jalen Hurts is dealing with a shoulder injury. That's the very latest from our NFL insider, Jonathan Jones. Hurts was injured in Sunday's win over the Chicago Bears, and that injury has now put Hurts' status in doubt for Saturday's Christmas Eve showdown with the Dallas Cowboys. Now, if Hurts can't play, it means that Gardner Minshew would likely get the call.
If it needs to be Gardner, how much of the offense changes, and where's your confidence level?
Yeah, you know, again, we are going to have to plan for both guys to play. We're going to have a plan for Jalen to play. We're going to have a plan for Gardner to play.
If Gardner Minshew does play, it seemed like him and Dallas Goedert had a connection last year in the game that he played. How big would that be to have Dallas back?
Yeah, you know, obviously, no matter who plays quarterback for us, Dallas Goedert is a weapon to, you know, for this football team.
Yeah, so missed 5 weeks with a broken a fracture in my shoulder somewhere. And they had me in a sling for a couple weeks. It was an upper body injury, so I was able to work on my legs more than anything. But being activated, knowing that I get to go out there, put the shoulder pads, the helmet on, Christmas Eve in Dallas, it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be exciting. And, you know, I'm just so happy to be back out there, being able to go to battle with my brothers.
Way back home with you, oh, jingle bells. Jingle all the way back home with you.
That's just routes on air. Puts it right out in front of Devontae Smith. That's an easy touchdown.
And this Dallas D gets the turnover. Oh, who's got it? Looks like Glenn has it.
You really had him on the ropes kind of there, third, obviously what you want to have.
Yeah, that's what we want him at, you know, and that's me being a leader in the secondary at all. That can't happen, you know. That's a play that changed the game, changed momentum. We just was back-to-back sacks, one strip sack, so we got to execute that better on the back end. But, yeah, that play got me hot, real hot.
I think we have a pretty diverse team as far as veterans and young guys. So I know the veteran guys understand, you know, how special of a team that we have and how special the time is in the league, and we're able to address that to the younger guys.
Let's go! Hey, man, I ain't got much to really rah-rah about today, man. Really, I just want to tell y'all boys, I'm thankful for y'all boys, man. I don't want to take me through with nobody on my birthday but y'all guys. Let's go ahead and go dominate these guys, man. One more time for y'all, boy. I appreciate y'all. Dan on three, 1, 2, 3.
Hey. Hey, fellas, bring it up. Hey, fellas, it start with us and the end with us. Every time we go out there, man, we need to be knocking off and knocking ass back every time. So, man, let's go out here, man. Let's have fun, play loose, and let's go out here and get this win. Win on three. 1, 2, 3.
Win. Let's go, man.
Eagles rush 4. Dalton. Sacks. Brandon Graham. New career high. His 10th.
And they was in the way too. Whoever was in the way, that's who was gonna pay for it. But you know, sitting out was never a question. I didn't want to end my career off an injury if I could help it. You know what I'm saying? So I felt like the Achilles injury is way different than what it was back then. So much more information on, you know, how to recover and come back from from it. And that was my mindset, man, just seeing the guys that I've seen before me. And my mindset was to come back strong.
Get him, because I'm getting double. Congratulations, bro.
Miles Sanders has a hole. Getting the ground game going. Sanders with a gain of 10 in the first play of this drive.
Here comes Jordan Mailata on the pull. They are creating great running lanes.
Mailata's the left tackle. He's in his fifth year, not just in the NFL, but in his fifth year playing football, period. And today's an extra special day for Jordan because his family is here to watch him play football for the first time. That's his mom, Maria, his dad, Tupac. Minshew has one-on-one for A.J. Brown. He's got A.J. Brown into the open field. Foot on the gas to the end zone. Touchdown, Eagles. 76 yards. They find the end zone in loud fashion. Nick Sirianni's team at 13-2. Best record in the NFL. 40-34 loss against Dallas last week.
They're sex right now, man.
Can they come from behind against the Saints? Eagles have all three timeouts. Second down and eight. Quick throw is picked off. Marshawn Lattimore read it. And a pick six in his first game back. It's the first interception of the season by a Saints corner. And it might be a backbreaker against the Eagles.
All right, what a difference a couple of weeks can make for the Eagles. What do you make of the situation that they are in right now?
My takeaway on the Eagles is it's a long season. They added a week to the season. It's now an 18-week season. 5 weeks ago, no one was touching the Eagles. But injuries happen.
Yeah.
Lane Johnson, Jalen Hurts, Chauncey Gardner-Johnson. Yesterday, Josh Sweat goes down. It's a long season. You don't win Super Bowls in November. You win them in February, and the Eagles are not the healthiest team right now. They need to get right.
And I think when you lose Jalen Hurts as your quarterback, it's going to be tough. But I will say their defense still played really well yesterday, only giving up 13 points in that game. That's winning football. The defense is still playing well. They just need to get Jalen Hurts back. He needs to be healthy. If he's healthy, and I'm an Eagles fan, I still feel confident in my team.
To you all, Barrett Brooks, Ron Jaworski, Ruben Frank, I'm Michael Barkan. They just cannot make it easy. This could go from one of the greatest Eagles seasons in history to easily, if it's not now already, one of the most frustrating. Let's just leave it at frustrating.
So disappointed in play calling, number one, because I don't know what they were calling on defense or offense in the beginning of the game. I didn't see the effort from players, not saying that they were jogging around, but there wasn't a sense of purpose and demeanor in which they were out there. The Saints brought that demeanor and that intensity to the game. So, I mean, is this a team that think they're so good that they can just walk on the field and think they can just do what they want to do?
The way they played today, it seemed like we show up, we got to win.
Yeah.
It doesn't work that way. This is the National Football League. Every player plays his heart out. The Eagles, in that first half, the team that I recognize defensively.
Are the Eagles battle-tested? Are the Eagles going through enough adversity? Because this is adversity right here. Like, you go from kings of the world riding high. Can anybody get in the Eagles' way? And you can't even beat the New Orleans Saints.
You know what they say, if young Metro don't trust you, you better run.
No, the real question I've had to try to figure out, Joy, Will, Dave, is why in the world is Jalen Hurts not getting the credit he deserves?
He could end up being a fourth or fifth round pick. Not early, but I think day three is where somebody brings him into the fold. And hey, let's face it, you're going to see what happens. Everybody's going to define what kind of quarterback Jalen Hurts is going to be.
In this draft, think of Jalen Hurts says about Carson Wentz is that we question whether or not Carson Wentz is going to get hurt. That's it. If Carson Wentz is healthy, nobody is worried about Jalen Hurts.
You know, can Hurts go toe-to-toe with one of the marquee guys at the position? Unless you believe that he already is that, I would need more than half a year to go, yep, I'd put him right there with all these other quarterbacks.
Good, healthy, developing insurance policy. This is a policy, Max, and that's it.
So the answer is no.
Okay, right now I have Jalen Hurts ranked 5th in MVP.
So for me, Skip, I think this is Josh Allen's war to lose. I'm going to say Josh Allen is 1, followed by closely by Patrick Mahomes, 2, and I got Jalen Hurts.
Think about it. If I told you you could have Jalen Hurts or the rest of the Philadelphia Eagles, you're taking the Eagles roster. And that right there is the definition of most value.
Jalen Hurts.
I'm done apologizing. I am done being persecuted for my strength. You people should be thanking Christ that I am who and what I am because you need me. You need me to save you. You do. I am the only one who possibly can. You're not the real heroes.
I'm a show for this city. On and off the field, man. And I think it's an all-inclusive thing. You know, so when we're in the league, we just turn it up. You know, it's... They're with us. Yeah, we on the field. We travel. They're with us, so...
We say it's a Philly thing.
A trip to the NFC Championship game up for grabs.
Close to the time.
Long time rivals meet up in the divisional round.
We work really hard for these opportunities.
We run it right at you now, Sam.
Finally, the week is over.
Second down and 8. First pass play from Jalen Hurts, who's well protected. Once Smith, perfectly thrown. Third and 3. Barkley swings out. Jones gets tripped up and dropped. And a team that had 15 more sacks than any other in the NFL gets its first one tonight.
Fourth down and 8. Guys to go for it.
$2.50. Ooh, that's the cheapest one. Stacking these underdogs. Run it, got there again. Told you from number get up an echelon. I get the stacking up. I'm untouchable. I get to represent. Money multiple. I'm at the top of the charts. Unapproachable. Pray by the love. Turbo the motor. Tic tac toe. Killing up vultures. Selling up bows.
It's always great to start fast.
I deserve rewards. Serving these boulders.
100 grand large. When
a
shot, that's a
total. Fill up the garage. I'm a mogul.
Ain't no facade. Ain't no fugazi.
I jump it off. I get paid. Drop to a rush. I'm going crazy.
Cut by the Giants in the offseason. Intercepts a pass right here.
Canyon Cup. Gotta get paid.
He punched it forward. He bent for the touchdown. The Giants killer has another one. Some of us thought this would be a close game.
One more time, Giant killer.
But so far, it has been total domination. They have been airtight on defense. They have been sensational on offense. Hurts is back. He's gonna go with the draw. He's gonna run. He's gonna score.
What you want from your leader, your number one guy? Have him out there like having Michael Jordan out there. He's your leader. He's your guy.
That's the end of the first half with the score. The Eagles, 28. The Giants, nothing.
Anytime you go up like 28-0, you know, it's definitely gonna be hard to fight out of that hole.
Even when we're up 28-0, it's, hey, we're starting again. And it's like it's 0-0.
They can't tap out now. Let's keep it on. Keep the pressure on.
16 first downs for Philly to just 3 for New York.
First and goal at the 8. Pistol for me.
Jones motions out. Barkley's going to take the direct snap. Hands it off to Matt Breida. And he finds the end zone. Touchdown, New York.
Fourth and 8. Under 3 minutes to play.
Trying to keep their hopes alive.
Deflected and almost picked off. Slay is all over.
I'm in year 10. Sometimes like people in year 10, they be tired of football. I am in year 10 and I'm up here whooping ass.
Come on, y'all. Let's go ahead and finish this the right way. Run that thing.
Kenneth Gainwell stays in.
Gainwell trying to get around the edge, and Kenneth Gainwell explodes all the way for another touchdown. Moves over 100 yards for the day in style.
First 100-yard rushing game in a playoff game is big. I'm proud of him. He runs hard.
The Philadelphia Eagles have reached the NFC Championship game.
We ain't ready to go home yet. We got a conference championship, and we got that bowl.
Proud of this team. Let's finish.
and they left no questions unanswered tonight.
We get to go and play to go to the Super Bowl next week.
Goes to Sanders up the middle. Touchdown! Miles Sanders, 6 yards. Eagles lead.
Purdy, who has been sensational.
And the pass goes up and it is intercepted, I believe. It's going to be a fumble. The arm has not quite come forward.
Hassan Reddick, he's been a bad dude all year.
Johnson, pressure, Reddick buries him.
Damn.
And the Eagles with a big sack and the big play, and Reddick takes it over.
Let's go! Broken fields, breaking tackles, running 23 yards.
49ers have found a way to hang in this game. Now tied up.
Jalen Hurts finds a target in the end zone.
Sanders gets it left side. Big room and a touchdown for Sanders to the end zone.
2 minute drive.
Ball is bobbled and it's on the ground and loose.
Now the Eagles say they have. Let's see. If they do, they do.
He just dropped it.
And it's Reddick who's got the two sacks and the strip sack, recovers the fumble.
Three
1 second to go.
They go to Scott. Tries to sleep. He's at the five. He pushes forward. He is in for the touchdown. Boston Scott.
Speed.
How physically tough we are and how mentally tough we are. You know, no matter what was going to happen in that game, I know these guys in this locker room are going to keep fighting.
Hurt again on the front. He sneaks, he pushes, and he is in. Touchdown, Jalen Hurts. The Philadelphia Eagles have won the NFC Championship 4-3-2-1. By the final score, the Eagles 31, the 49ers 7. Attention, air traffic control. A flock of Eagles is heading to Arizona.
Mr. Reese, pack your bags. We're going to the Super Bowl.
We are, and we cannot wait.
Hey, guys, bring it up real quick. Awesome job. Awesome job. We're one win away.
Yeah.
We're one win away from something that we all dreamed about for a very long time. I don't know. We all dream about it now, right, being in this position. Some of us started dreaming about it when we were 2 years old. Some of us in high school. Some of us just when we got professionally. But we all dreamed about this. All right, so it's pretty special. But remember this. The goal wasn't just to get there. We got one more. Might as well win the whole thing. Let's go. Hey, lot to be thankful for. We'll get the schedule to you. Great job. Happy for everybody in here. It's a special group of men. Let's go finish this off. Let's go.
There's like a 6 or 7 year old Jalen on a high school field, like trying to hop in the drills. Is
yeah,
that right?
Yeah, the summer conditioning programs. The little quarterback drills, running back drills, receiver drills, all of it. You know, I just wanted to play ball.
Mm-hmm. I think that's something that not everyone knows about you, that your connection to this game runs deep.
Runs very deep.
When do you think you fell in love with it?
Man, my dad always tells the story. You know, my brother grew up, you look at old pictures. My brother grew up, he had a basketball in his hand, like as a child, like 2-3 years old. Mm-hmm. For whatever reason, I had a football in mind, you know, and, you know, it's always been in me, you know, and just my childhood, the way I was raised, and what I've gone through, it's something that I love, and I give my all towards.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody.
There is no point where you'll arrive. It's only the journey.
January 8th comes in to take over for the guy that won that game.
Jalen getting some pressure down the middle. He throws a strike to Irv Smith for the first down. Just inside the 16, quarterback draw. Jalen Hurts, touchdown! Incomplete, and Alabama has won it. Lofting left, going for the end zone, and he's caught for the touchdown.
To something here. I think this young quarterback is finding his groove. Him and his play caller, Nick Sirianni. I'll tell you what.
Yeah, I mean, you see it just about every Sunday. You see him making a play out of the pocket or extending a play with his legs and making a big throw with his arm. He's definitely someone that's really difficult to defend. I'm glad he's on our team, that's for sure.
What we strive for and how we're able to overcome. So I'm very happy about that today.
You guys are a winning team now for the first time, and I think you're qualified for the playoffs if it ended today.
I'll cut you off.
What does that mean?
I'm going to cut you off. I'm not in the business of talking about anything but being in the moment.
I'm the man. Go ahead and tell everybody.
say one thing. How the week that we put together, that's what showed up out there. We work off. So man, let's do that each and every day, man. Don't take no moment for granted. You know what I'm saying? Cause that right there, that's what we showed up all week. All week. It showed up out there, man. So don't get it twisted. It's on us. It's on us. And it's how we prepare each and every week. Go ahead, Jalen.
Exact same thing he just said. We prepared our best and we played our best. When our best was needed. Now, I don't put no limit to this. Continue to grow and continue to lay everything on the line right now. Lay everything on the line. These are once in a lifetime opportunities we got right in front of us in our hand. So what the you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Mentality we gotta have, man, it don't have to be nothing different than what we done practiced all month. Yeah, let's work your ass off every day. Let's stay together. We're a family. We unite together. And we go dog shit together. That's what we're going to do. That's what we do. So enjoy this, huh? Enjoy this.
Don't
understand.
Going to do it. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah